You have Braxton going down.
Obviously, it's devastating.
Hearing everybody like, man, our season's over.
When I heard the news, my wife said it's going to be a bad year.
I was just kind of sitting back and just like, we'll see.
Month has been the injury to Ohio State quarterback Braxton Miller. He first injured the shoulder in the bowl game against Clemson, rehabbed through much of the season, and then sadly re-injured it in a non-contact play on August 18th. Successful surgery, but Braxton Miller out for the year. A huge loss for the Buckeyes, as Braxton Miller was a legitimate Heisman hopeful. Well, that puts the weight on the shoulders of a redshirt freshman named J.T. Barrett. He played for Wichita Falls Rider, was injured 2 years ago, sat out all of last season while he rehabbed, and is about to take his first competitive snap in a football game.
Go deep. He's got him.
Oh, does he ever? Oh, my goodness. Devin Smith, untouched. Touchdown, Ohio State.
Right now, right here, right now, right here, right now, right here. Barrett on third down and a long four. Slant complete. Michael Thomas is going to go. Touchdown, Ohio State.
To be made for an Ohio State at the end of the season, depending on how things shake out?
Yeah, I'm on your side. I completely agree with you. I just think it's way too early. There's too much football to be played.
Winning record. 2 yards or more. Sack and the ball is loose. And just batted out of the end zone for a safety. Joey Bosa delivering the hit on Gunnar King.
Edsel's tenure, they've had bad luck with injuries.
Deep in the back of the end zone, it is caught. There's a flag down. Was it a catch? Yes. Touchdown, Michael Thomas.
No, I turned wrong. Left your heart torn. Is that what devils do? Took you so long, where only fools go. I shook the angel and young. Now I'm rising from the crowd, rising up to you. Filled with all the strength I find, there's nothing I can't do.
bring down angels like you. Now I'm rising from the ground, rising up to you. Feel with all the strength.
In the country coming in pass efficiency and very efficient again today. And officially into the end zone for a touchdown for Ohio State.
It out, cross the 40 to the 41 to Godwin. They're still on their side of the 50, but they've got a first down at the 46. Hackenberg doesn't want to take that sack Todd was talking about, and he lofts one out, and it's almost intercepted. Nearly picked off by Eli Apple.
Position, and that's where Bose is working.
Second down and 10. James, the tight end, on the move. Ohio State almost jumped offside. Hackenberg, wide out screen again. This one's to Geno Lewis. Broke one tackle. Broke another. He's got a first down.
Only about 6 yards, so you're just pecking away at it, but you can't take a sack.
Now you can see the clock's running, and there comes the sack, and it's Bosa. That's the last thing you want to happen, and he gives the, well, just the shrug for another sack. Fourth of the night now. At the 28. Hackenberg throws outside, tipped, almost intercepted. Godwin's up to the top of the screen. That's where Hackenberg's looking. He goes to the end zone. It's too high for Godwin, incomplete. In Dublin, he had a game winner on the season opener. Sam Ficken, 31-yard field goal to tie. Up and good. 35. Penn State in one play, making overtime harder on themselves. Hackenberg got a lot of protection that time, and he drills it to Hamilton. Down to the 16-yard line. He'll do it again. Goes to the right side, and I think he backpedaled his way to an 13 passes tonight.
There it is.
There's the throw, and it's Hamilton, and he's got it at the 2. Overtime. Belton in the Wildcat. He'll take the snap straight ahead. He got there. Touchdown, Penn State. At the 25, it's Ohio State's turn. They need a touchdown. Elliott got about 3, maybe 4. Appears at this point. Second and 7. Elliott to the line of scrimmage. No, it's Barrett on the keeper. He had me. Great run. And he's down around the 5-yard line. Again, Ezekiel Elliott with Barrett. Barrett keeps it again, and he's in. Touchdown, Ohio State.
Great patience by Barrett on the mesh point. Sells it, and you see everybody go to Elliott. And that only happens because JT Barrett shows excellent patience and doesn't rush the play. Different guys as the Wildcat quarterback some huge runs on that first overtime possession.
Elliott stood up by Hall again at the 10-yard line. At the 10. Play action. Barrett all day to throw. Now he's going to run with it. Got away from the first man. Tripped up as he got down within a yard of the first down marker again. Hierman comes in front to lead the way. And he goes straight ahead for the first down, and it might be the touchdown. Yes, it is. Barrett for the score. Second overtime, Penn State. First down at the 25. Lynch with some blockers in front trying to find an opening. He doesn't find one. Got back to the line of scrimmage. That's about it. Joshua Perry was one of the first guys there. Looking left the whole way and goes to James, the tight end, with the catch out of bounds around the 21. Up to the top of your screen. Hackenberg rolling that way. Throws on the run to the corner, trying to get it to Hamilton in the end zone. Incomplete. And Penn State's down to one snap.
Well, took a shot here on the third down play. Overthrown. Tough throw to make on the move. Good coverage downfield. It was Von Bell that was in coverage on Hamilton.
They've got to get to the 15-yard line just to keep this football game alive. Again, it's Lewis and Hamilton to the right. This is the ball game right here. If they don't get a first down, it's over. Fourth and six. Hackenberg. Hit and dropped, and the game is over, and it's Bosa.
Well, this is a mismatch. Somehow Bosa got matched up on Akeel Lynch. That's a mistake up front for Penn State, and he just overpowered Lynch and drove Lynch right in to Christian Hackenberg. Good scheme by Ohio State, bad protection by Penn State, and Ohio State gets the victory.
And a game that was really, we thought, almost dead in the water at halftime at 17 to nothing, became a classic. And in the end, Ohio State stays unbeaten in Big Ten play at 3-0. They go to 6-1 as they win it in double overtime by a touchdown.
Yeah. Hey. Yeah. Hey. Yeah. Boys.
To the end zone. Caught for a touchdown by Devin Smith.
From the brawn and blue-collar battles of the Big Ten and these two schools are titans in it. Their last encounter was the conference championship a year ago.
I've had this game circled personally since the minute I stepped off that field last year.
Everybody was doubting us, and we know we can go out there and play this game.
We have to take this one in order to get where we need to get.
A lot's at stake. We know they're coming for us. We're coming for them.
I'm not afraid to take a stand. Take a stand. Everybody, everybody, come take my hand.
Tonight, the rematch to stay in the playoff picture, to avenge last year's loss, or confirm it, and to prove who's the best in the Big Ten for the playoffs.
This is a new year, new dreams.
For pride.
We're still chasing our success.
For proof on Saturday Night Football.
To the defense. Barrett hands it off. Elliott runs near side. Again, gets the corner. A big gain. Still running inside the 30. Cuts it back. Elliott down inside the 5. Barrett, this pressure, delivers far side. Smith, over the shoulder, catch at the 20.
We're too long living in the same old lives. Yeah, I feel too cold to live, too young to die. Yeah, will you walk the line like it's there to choose? Yeah, just forget the wins, it's the best to use.
Sweet West Virginia last week. Barrett, a first down throw on a slant, complete. Running free is Michael Thomas to the 40. A foot race, and Thomas will win it. 79 yards for Keyshawn Johnson's nephew, his seventh touchdown of the season. Wow. 288 total offense. Play action. Barrett loops downfield. Throws for Smith. Touchdown!
It's the same religion, just a different name. Won't you follow me into the jungle?
Second and six. Elliott cuts it back. Zeke Elliott zipping to the end zone. Now that could do it for Ohio State.
The people that have not seen Ohio State play since Virginia Tech, I think they're somewhat mesmerized by this Ohio State offense.
I am.
I think everybody is. I think Urban Meyer is. Zeke Elliott running the football. We've seen the decision making by JT Barrett, the big playability from the wide receivers, and let's not forget the much maligned offensive line after the Virginia Tech game. They've stuck together. They got tested. They went to Penn State, got tested there. They've come together as a group. They should feel very good about the way they played tonight. JT Barrett set this touchdown up with a huge run. We wondered if they'd get a little bit conservative. Would they continue to be aggressive? They got aggressive, but they did it by running the football. And they're up 18 again on Michigan State.
Here's Barrett finding a hole. Look out. He's past the 25-yard line. Barrett to midfield. Being chased inside the 30. Barrett inside the 20 to the 10. Barrett for the touchdown. Snow starting to pick up here. Third down and long. Barrett in trouble. Gets rid of it. And it's caught. Looses Marshall inside the 20. He'll take it to the house. It's 13-0 Buckeyes.
All I really know is 100. Nothing left. 100. Till nothing left. All I really know is 100. Nothing left. 100. Till nothing left. All I really know is 100. Nothing left. 100. Till nothing left. All I really know is 100. Nothing left. 100. Till nothing left. All I really know is.
Feeling like Jackie Robinson, rocking a 42 in my Dodger fit, gripping the arm that was just like my pitch. Crowd the opposite, saying that I should quit, but I don't throw all of it. You can hate, but you can't hurt me. You can hate, but you can't hurt me.
Young Xander Diamant at the helm. Up the middle, big hole for Ezekiel Elliott, and Elliott into the clear. Elliott is going to take it all the way for the touchdown.
I'm still smiling. I ain't eating much, but I'm smiling. I'd rather be in the jungle than the will of God than anywhere else outside it. But my hope ain't in this life. A good career book for years, a book and peers, a good look just won't suffice. But homie, my life is hidden in Christ. My life is hidden in Christ. Give me 99 problems plus one God here. The result is
all I really know is 100. Nothing left. 100.
Jalen Marshall near midfield. Ohio State sets up the return. Marshall at the 47 of Ohio State with running room. Marshall to the 45 and into the clear. Marshall breaks the tackle. He's gone. Jalen Marshall with a touchdown.
He came back right from the game and started catching punts out in the snow because he was so upset with himself and make up for it. And I guess that was practice.
Marshall in motion gets it. Marshall on the sweep. Breaks the tackle. Touchdown. Jalen Marshall.
The strength of his arms when he was briefly out.
They're happy to have him back as Diamant going to the air. And it's intercepted. Picked off by Powell. Powell inside the 20 and down to the 15. The 15 on first down. Barrett lofting for the end zone. What a catch! A one-handed stab by Jalen Marshall. And the Marshall claim has come through in the second half. And Ohio State closes it in on a division title. Since David Boston did it against Indiana on the road in 1998. And here he goes again. Jalen Marshall down the sideline. Touchdown number four in the second half.
Well, we talked about with Urban Meyer on Friday about Jalen Marshall muffing that punt in Minnesota, him coming right back, going out in the snow and catching punts, and he felt bad, and he thought if they would have lost that game up in Minnesota, it would have been his fault, and didn't want it to happen again, and maybe he should go out and practice catching punts again tonight. It's working good for him.
Extra point is good, and it has been all Jalen Marshall. Four touchdowns today in the second half.
Scarlet and gray, maize and blue. Every November, the air cools and the leaves fall and the colors mix on a furious palette for an annual prize. It's a game of legends and legacies, history and hostility. Woody, Archie, Charles, the Big House, the Horseshoe, Doc the Eye, Hugh the victors. It's not just game time. It's time for the game.
Ladies and gentlemen, the pride of the Buckeyes, the Ohio State University marching band.
Brought down for a loss by Ochimudia. Some pushing and shoving after the play. We haven't seen a lot of extracurricular activity in this game as Barrett still down for Ohio State.
He got bent back pretty significantly when he went down. Ochimudia had him and it was wrestling him to the ground.
Oh boy. And obviously, Braxton Miller is out for the year. Cardale Jones, a sophomore from Cleveland, is the next man up. Oh man, look at the legs there with Ojemudia having made the tackle, and boy, that looks bad. Recruiting director has the story in Cardale Jones.
Well, Cardale Jones is out of Glenville, Cleveland High School. It's been a football factory. It's where Ted Ginn went. He's a pocket guy. Wasn't recruited to play in this style of offense, but he's adapted. Not going to have that sudden running game. And that's what you're seeing right now with Jalen Marshall at quarterback.
Michigan 44-yard line with a 7-point lead, 5 minutes remaining. Cardale Jones, the quarterback. Elliott has the first down and more, and Elliott's going to have a touchdown. On fourth and one, Elliott takes it to the house. Four-yard touchdown sprint by Ezekiel Elliott, and the Buckeyes have a 2-touchdown lead. Michigan be over after four seasons. Here comes a blitz. It's picked up. Gardner, though, is wrapped up by Bosa. The ball's out. Darren Lee's got it for Ohio State. Going for the exclamation point. Touchdown, Buckeyes!
Peyton Manning, Bill.
Lucas Oil Stadium in downtown Indianapolis, Indiana. Welcome to the Ford Big Ten Championship pregame show on Fox, sponsored by the Ford F-Series, built Ford tough. Inside, we're ready for the 2014 championship game as the 13th-ranked Wisconsin Badgers prepare to take on the 5th-ranked Ohio State Buckeyes. Hi, everybody. Gus Johnson along with my partner, Charles Davis. And welcome to Naptown. CD, I just got one thing to say. Cardale Jones. The whole state of Ohio is counting on Cardale Jones.
And the message from his team, from his coaches, you don't have to be Braxton Miller. You don't have to be JT Barrett. Just be the best Cardale Jones you can be tonight.
Here's Jones. Steps back. Looks downfield. Lets it go. He's got a receiver, Devin Smith. Oh! He made the catch! Touchdown, Buckeyes! Cardale Jones! Jones handing it off. Elliott again! Watch out! 40, 30, 20! They're playing that Buckeye swag song already! 81 yards!
In the first college football playoff. So let's take a look at the bracket right now, and we will start at the top. College football playoff rankings brought to you by AT&T. Sitting at number one, Alabama holds its spot after winning the SEC championship. The Crimson Tide will be in New Orleans to play a semifinal in the Sugar Bowl. At number two, as you see, Nick Saban.
Wait for it.
You know it's happening.
Okay.
Hey, that's a golf clap.
Right?
Okay, we'll take
the regular They've never done that.
You know what? I will say this. I thought they showed more excitement winning the SEC in Saban's comments yesterday about how important it was and enjoyable to coach this team. They get the reward. They are the number one team.
Let's go to practice. Yep. Yeah. Back to work.
Alabama, the number one team according to the College Football Playoff Selection Committee. Sitting at number two, the Oregon Ducks, champions of the Pac-12. 1-2, it doesn't really matter. Alabama plays in the Sugar Bowl. That's close to them. Oregon gets to play in Pasadena in the Rose Bowl. And Mark Helfrich, by the way, tried to reach him last night for College Football Final. Let me show you how a college football coach works. Went to Hawaii recruiting. Not for vacation, recruiting.
The next Mariota?
That's worked out pretty well for him. That,
St. Louis
island.
High School. Where
you betcha. Find a quarterback at that high school juggernaut on the island. So Oregon is number two. That's why we don't have Helfrich's reaction right now. He's been out working. We'll do our best to hear from the Ducks. We have a reporter out there, Maria Taylor, as they are number two as they compete for the national championship. So now
you're
the
jump to six.
Team,
what are you going to do? You're going to three. What are we doing?
Three. I think we know who three is going to be.
Knowles.
Let's take number three.
Florida State.
It is Florida State. So Florida State moved up to number three, and they will play Oregon in Pasadena on New Year's afternoon.
And you've got last year's Heisman Trophy winner potentially against this year's Heisman Trophy winner playing in the Rose Bowl.
And a lot further to go for the fans to travel and a tougher matchup, yep. I believe, for Florida State.
You're excited at all about being there?
That's
for
pretty good. That's a pretty good one.
Yeah, I'm going to be there, too, and that doesn't stink. Let me tell you that. Oregon and Florida State, one national semifinal. So now it's the three teams we anticipated. They don't know their fate just yet. And here's how we're going to do it this time. I'm going to go ahead and show you number four, and then we'll pop out number five and six. None of us know who it is. So who will play Alabama? And it will be the Buckeyes of Ohio State, champions of the Big Ten that make it into the College Football Playoff, another 12-win season under Urban Meyer. And this one pays off with a spot in the playoff.
And you get Urban Meyer,
Nick Saban,
and Nick Saban in a Sugar Bowl.
One half of the bracket has been emphatically filled by the Ducks of Oregon. A resounding win in the Rose Bowl over Florida State has put them in the national championship game. Now we'll meet the other half. Winners of 11 straight, champions of the Big Ten, Ohio State, and here come the Buckeyes.
Per game.
On a second and 13, just a straight handoff to Ezekiel Elliott trying to get wide right, and he got the corner and a hurdle, and now Elliott off the races down the sideline. First and goal, Ohio State.
Drop more guys.
They're going to bring an extra one, including Collins. And the ball is long and caught by Devin Smith.
Go time.
Oh, shit's about to go down.
Think they'd be sure to get three, but they want more, if at all possible, with 19 seconds left. End around, and now a pass coming up. Spencer to the end zone. Thomas.
Did he get a foot down?
Yes. Touchdown. Yes. Boy, did they ever do it with style, huh?
Well, Cyrus Jones is in perfect position. This is not a play that fooled Alabama, but the ball is thrown in the right spot. Did he get a foot down?
Wow.
I think he did.
There's his left foot. There's still some green showing before you see the chalk.
Wow.
What a catch and what unbelievable balance. Six when it's third and eight or more. Jones waited to the last minute and let it fly. He's got Devin Smith. Touchdown.
And thanks for asking. Couldn't slow down, so we had to crash it. You use plastic, we bout cash. I see some people ahead that we gon' pass, yeah.
I never feared death or dying. I only fear never trying. I am whatever I am, only God can
Sims, quick throw, intercepted. Picked off by Steve Miller. Miller, defensive lineman dream. Touchdown.
The same ones that I ride with, be the same ones that I doubt with,
put
it all out on the line with.
Ezekiel Elliott, and he's got an opening. Elliott, off to the races. Can they catch him? No, they can't. Touchdown. For this young man, 40 carries, 450 yards, a career high of 230 right now. And he had a 54-yarder earlier in the game. This one takes the cake, 85 yards for the touchdown. Going into the Big Ten Championship, people wondered if the Buckeyes even belonged in the college football playoff. Then they took care of the Badgers 59-0. And right now they're up 42-28 on number one Alabama.
Spirit, I'm feeling like a kill inside. Financial outbreak, I'm free, but I ain't out yet. Riding with the plug, so I'm close to the outlet. At the red light rim, sitting offset. I look better on your girl than outfit.
Stuck to the plan. Always said
the maybe the last play. Sims. Hail Mary, not answered, intercepted. Ohio State's going to win it. The dream continues for the Buckeyes. The nightmare starts. For number one Alabama, they are no more.
All
always fast and fashionable. White top silver pants and camo tights. Their fans are known as being loud per capita in Autzen Stadium. But get ready for the roar as the Buckeyes come in here. Perhaps 70% of this place, Ohio State fans. The first of its kind, and no other big event really feels quite like this. A far less corporate crowd, Kirk, than we usually see. This is college football passionate fans in here tonight.
You can feel a buzz in the air. You know something special is about to occur.
Jones comes at Kirk already down 7-0. That's what Helfrich was hoping for. Can they confuse this guy? Can they test his patience?
Yeah, they want to put pressure on him, and he's obviously coming in with a ton of confidence. Hasn't played a lot of football. Started the Big Ten championship game against Wisconsin. Played well. Played even better last week in the Sugar Bowl against Alabama. He and Ezekiel Elliott will be the key. A combination of the vertical passing game and also the tough inside running and outside running of Elliott.
Elliott is behind, the 6'5", 250-pound sophomore from Cleveland. They give it to the sophomore from St. Louis in a short game. Gifted receiver on deep balls in college football. As Elliott takes the handoff, barrels free again. Zeke Elliott down near the goal line. On first and goal, Jones bobbled the snap. Now fires far side. Bennett, touchdown, Ohio State.
Say do what you want, say prayers at night. And I'm saying them, cause I'm so devout. Till the love runs out, till the love runs out. Check out my mind.
Elliott cuts it back. And first down inside the 10, first and goal. Another huge game, approaching 200 yards.
And Billy Price, the left guard, and Jeff Heirmann, the tight end, pulling around again. And the patience from Zeke Elliott on these runs and the vision are the reason he's able to pop through there. And again, of course, he has outstanding quickness and acceleration for his size.
Overshadowed throughout the Big Ten season by Melvin Gordon and so many other good bats, but this guy has come on very strong in the last half of the season. He's got it again. Elliott! Touchdown, Ohio State, on the final play of the quarter. Mariota, high throw incomplete. Elliott dodged the eye of this national championship win. And they'll fill in the rest.
No doubt about it.
Wow. What a three-game run for this team, for this quarterback.
And for that red line.
Shelly Meyer, Urban's wife, giving Elliott a well-deserved hug.
Never would have had a chance under the old system to show how good a football team they are. What a year for the Big Ten. We've all beaten up the Big Ten, and then Jim Delaney said there's been reason to. What a strong last month for this conference.
Yeah, January 1st
for these guys.
Yep.
Mariota escapes. This will be the final play of the game. Heaves it, and it's not fitting. It ends with an interception. And the Ohio State Buckeyes are the first national champions of the playoff era.
Pursuit of the championship, the chase. Tonight, where's it taking you?
The chase is complete. It's done. It's over. They accepted their final mission, their final assignment, and their final directive, and they did it. That was our whole motto, mantra this entire last couple weeks. Job well done, and we're very grateful. Thank you.
First, I want to congratulate both of these fine teams for a great effort tonight and all during the season. And now, on behalf of the conferences and schools that manage this awesome new event, it's my honor to present the first college football playoff national championship trophy to Coach Urban Meyer and the Ohio State Buckeyes.
Congratulations, once again, you're third, but you're first with the Ohio State Buckeyes. What do you have to say to the faithful who have come here to this great stadium to watch you guys win a championship?
Well, we play football for a lot of reasons. We play it for the great state of Ohio. We play it for an incredible university, the Ohio State University. But most importantly, we play it for each other. This is one of the closest teams in college football history. We play it for each other.
It's a privilege and an honor to be a part of this national championship team in 2014. But guess what? We got another year to do it. So go Bucks.